Come on, let's clap our hands in the building tonight. Come on, we just want to do this little song. And we know that you all know it, so y'all gonna help us sing tonight. Is that all right? Y'all gonna help us sing tonight? Come on, we're gonna sing Emmanuel. Y'all been to church before. Come on, let's rock a little bit. Come on. Let's sing it from the top. Come, let us adore him.
Come.
Come, let us adore him.
Come, let us adore him.
Say, kneel down before him.
Kneel down before him.
We worship and adore
worship
him.
Worship and adore him.
Come on, say it one more time. Come, let us adore him.
Come.
Come, let us.
Come, let us adore him.
Kneel down before
Him. Kneel down before Him.
Come on, we lift our hands and worship.
Worship and adore Him.
Come on, let's sing it out real loud. Come on, say, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, everybody in the room, clap your hands. Come on, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Say that we love Him. Yes, we do.
Emmanuel.
Come on, this is what our holiday season is about. Come on, say, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, let's say it one more time. Lift up your voice in the room. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on. Say He is God with us. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, lift your hands and give Him glory. Come on. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, let's clap in this room. Come on. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on. Said we worship You.
We worship You.
Come on, if you worship Him, come on, clap right now. Come on, clap. Let me hear it.
We worship You.
Come on, let's sing one more time, y'all. Come, let us adore Him. Come.
Come.
Come, let us adore Him.
Come, let us adore Him.
Kneel down.
Kneel down before Him.
Shall we worship and adore Him?
Worship and adore Him.
Let's get some harmony in here, y'all. Y'all ready? Come on, let's sing it. Come.
Come.
Come, let us adore.
Come, let us adore Him.
Worship and adore Him.
Worship and adore Him.
Come on, everybody in the room, help us sing and say, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, clap your hands and let's hear it. Say, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, He is God with us. Come on, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, let's give Him glory in the house. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, let's the sopranos, let's sing it for Him. Emmanuel. Come on, I'm coming for the sopranos in the audience. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
I hope y'all learn fast because y'all going to have to sing. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, y'all ready? Y'all ready? Here we go. Come on, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Let me hear it in the audience. Where the sopranos at? Emmanuel. Come on, y'all better sing like y'all know it. Come on, Emmanuel. Come on, sing it again. Emmanuel. Come on, y'all better sing it one more time. Say, Emmanuel. Altos, we're going to teach it.
Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Okay.
Say, Emmanuel, say.
Emmanuel.
I just want to hear what the alto got. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Say, say, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Where the altos? Altos only, where you at? Y'all better sing, Gary. Come on, Emmanuel. Come on, I got y'all rhythm right here. Come on, Emmanuel. Go on, say. Come on, y'all better sing. I ain't never had a choir this big. Come on. Come on, tenor, stand for a way to break. Say, Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Y'all better sing. I got two tenors, fellas. See what y'all gonna do.
Emmanuel.
I only got two. It's about 50 of y'all out here, right? Come on.
Emmanuel.
Come on, I know y'all fellas, y'all ain't gonna let me down, right?
Emmanuel.
Where the tenors at? Here we go. One, two, Emmanuel. Oh, come on, fellas, come on. Emmanuel, reach for it. Now I hear you. Come on, don't make me look bad. Come on, Emmanuel. Oh, y'all better sing. Come on, one more time, Emmanuel. Everybody, no music. Here we go. Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Come on, look at him like you love him. Say, I love you. Yes, I do.
Emmanuel.
5, say Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Said we worship.
We worship.
Come
you.
On, play Menzies. We worship.
We worship.
I say we worship you.
We worship you.
Come on, give yourselves a hand. You all are awesome choir. God bless you.
Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Dixon and Dixon and all his reindeers pulling on the reins. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. So hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He's got a bag that's filled with toys for boys and girls again. Hear those sleigh bells jingle, jangle. So jump in bed and cover your head, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Care if you're rich or poor, he loves you just the same. Santa Claus knows we're all God's children, that's everything life. So fill your hearts with Christmas cheer, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. He'll come around when chimes ring out that it's Christmas morn again. Peace on earth will come to all if we just follow the light. So let's give thanks to the Lord. Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Dixon and Blitzen and all his reindeers pulling on the rain. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
Hello.
Good evening.
I'm Della.
I'm Jim.
Actually, he's Mr. James Dillingham Young.
Yes, dear. I'm Mr. James Dillingham Young, but I'm only Dillingham when my salary is $30 a week. But lately, my salary has been so small, only $20 a week, that now Dillingham doesn't seem appropriate. So perhaps you should all call me Mr. James D. Young.
Nonsense, my love. To me, rich or poor, you will always be my wonderful Jim. What does your weekly salary have to do with our love?
Everything, Della. My salary terms I'm able to buy you, and all I want to give you, no, shower upon you.
Again, nonsense, my love. To me, your weekly salary means little. Our being together is everything.
Della and I, we just got married, so really you can call us newlyweds.
And this is our first apartment, Jim and mine.
Well, not much of an apartment, Della. No rug.
No matter.
Old, torn, faded, tattered curtains.
No matter.
Very little furniture.
How much more do we really need?
An old sofa that some family long ago discarded as worthless.
But it's still very useful for us.
And two rickety chairs to send desperate need of upholstering.
But are still very, very comfortable.
I feel so bad, Della. I can't give you more.
Again, how much more do we really need?
Would you might not feel we need, Della, but I feel I want to give you. A gold chandelier, gleaming over a long mahogany table, holding a shiny polished silver tea service, on top of a very dainty Belgium lace tablecloth.
My funny, silly Jim. A candle will do exactly what a golden chandelier will. And a polished silver tea service would only bring in so much more work to keep polishing and polishing it so that it stays shiny and shiny.
But if I had my way, your hands would never do all that work.
But how?
Servants.
Servants?
Yes, lots and lots of servants in every room of our huge house, if you need.
Not even the King and Queen of England can boast about such luxurious grandness.
Ah, my love, if only I were able but to provide even half of what my love desires to give you, You have one that any king or queen ever dared to treasure.
But my wonderful Jim, those are very wonderful thoughts. Thank you. But your love has already provided me with more than any king or queen could ever desire.
What?
This apartment, little though it may be, is our home. And with our love, yours for me, mine for you, we're gonna make this apartment beautiful.
But I wanna do so much more for you.
Again, how much more do we really need?
You don't think I believe that, Della?
It's true.
Then someday. Oh dear, I gotta get to work.
Not for at least another hour.
I can't be late. I really can't be late. Not today, the day before Christmas.
Christmas. It's Christmas Eve and we still haven't decorated this little apartment of ours.
The truth, Della, we've had no money to buy decorations. We're broke!
We have a few decorations. We'll put them up now.
Now?
Of course.
I gotta get to work.
Not for at least another hour.
You're right. With the few decorations we got, our entire apartment will be decorated. With 50 minutes left to just look around and see all the decorations.
Well, here's our box of Christmas decorations.
What should I put where?
These are for our tree.
What tree?
The tree in our imagination.
And this beautiful bow.
Also for our tree.
No. Such a beautiful bow is only made for one purpose. I do know your lovely hair. Such beautiful hair, Della. Such long, beautiful hair. With this on, it'll be made even more beautiful. But I gotta get to work, because my boss never stayed while I was late. Sorry, Miss Crockerty. I tried to get to work this morning. I really did. But my new bride, you should see her, Mr. Crockerty. Wear her long brown hair that flows. No, cascades down her back while framing her lovely brown dancing eyes. So you see, Miss Crockerty, my wife and I were dancing and singing, decorating our tiny apartment and making a Merry Christmas for ourselves. But then she'll say, what about our customers, Mr. Young? And then she'll bellow, they too want a Merry Christmas. And then she'll snap. Shouldn't you look more closely at that precious fob of yours?
That's quite a wonderful fob to be making such harsh demands on you.
Yes, dear. It's my most wonderful possession. My most prized possession. And next to you, what I treasure most in life.
So you tell me often.
This fob belonged to my father, to his father before him.
A family heirloom indeed.
A someday handout to our son.
Someday.
But I gotta get to work. See you this evening, Della. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Jim. Merry Christmas, Jim.
Bell,
165, 170, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87? Only 187. Seriously. I've been saving up every penny I possibly could for months. I must have miscounted. Nope. Still 187. Jeez. I don't know how this could have happened. I've been saving up all the money I possibly could for months. Hello, Mr. Vegetable Man. Could I please have those two tomatoes? They're rather bruised, so surely you'll sell them to me for less. No, thank you, Mr. Grocer. Only a pint of milk today. I'm trying to save as many pennies as I possibly can. And I did. I saved 60 of them. But what will 60 pennies buy? Two bruised tomatoes? A pint of milk? Some almost spoiled meat? A few spongy potatoes? But no wonderful gift for my gym. Please. Look at all these wonderful people out here. Happy people, rushing about buying gifts for their loved ones. Doing what I most want to be doing. Please. If only there was a way I could buy Jim a gift. But what could I buy with $1.87, even if the shops stay open all Christmas Eve? I could never make that happen, but I wonder.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own. More than you could ever know. Make my wish come true.
Oh, And why should I do that, Mr. Young?
I just got to leave work before all the shops close.
But it's Christmas Eve, Mr. Young.
That's exactly why I have to leave.
Eh?
I gotta buy the most beautiful gifts for my new bride. You should see her, Miss Crockerty. She's...
You should have thought about buying her gift before Christmas Eve.
I did. I've really been thinking about buying my little gifts for the longest time. If you see her, Miss Crockerty, with her long brown hair that flows, no, cascades, down her back while framing her lovely brown dancing eyes. So you see?
Well, you're just gonna have to buy her a Christmas present during my time.
I will, Miss Crockerty, but I'll make up the time. It just wouldn't be Christmas if I didn't buy my Della a gift.
What are you planning to buy her?
That's just it. I don't know. I have so little money.
Then you best be going.
In an hour, Miss Crockerty?
Right now, Mr. Young. With very little money, you have to search all afternoon to find a fitting gift for such a beautiful and wondrous bride.
Thank you, Miss Crockerty. Thank you. Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you too, and your new bride. Trust you to find the right gift for her.
Now look, I've only got $1.90 saved up over the last several months. Please, Mr. Taylor, make me a less fine suit so I can save several pennies. Please, Mr. Barber, not quite a full cut today. I'm trying to save pennies so I can buy my new bride a gift. Please, Miss Crockerty, I'll take no lunch and I'll gladly work into the afternoon, even into the night, if I can only earn a few more pennies. But with all that, I still only got $1.90. So what can I buy that'll be beautiful enough for my Della for $1.90? And Miss Crocker gave me the whole afternoon to search the shops.
In the meadow we can build a snowman.
Hello.
Hi, ma'am.
Where's Madame Saffroni?
What's your business with Madame Saffroni?
Will she buy my hair?
Well, I see. Madame Saffroni? Madame Saffroni?
Yes?
Will you buy her hair?
I do buy hair.
Then please, please, Madame Saffroni, buy mine.
Well,
my hair is very long and smooth, even silky. Just the kind of hair woven into the finest of wigs. A wig made from my hair will be prized by any woman, I'm certain of it.
You sound quite desperate on this Christmas Eve, Miss...
Mrs. James Dillingham Young. I'm a new bride, and I want to make the first gift I ever buy my wonderful gem something truly wonderful, but I have no money.
And that's why you want to sell your hair to me.
Jim loves my long hair so much.
Then to cut it off?
But I love him so much more. I just couldn't go through Christmas without getting him a gift.
Let me see what I can do. Should I buy her hair?
Yes.
For how much?
$20.
All right. I'll buy your hair for
$20. $20? What a wondrous gift $20 will buy. Quickly, Madame Saffroni, cut my hair.
This way.
Gary Middle School, and we're going to sing one more song for you. Mr. Antoine Gaines is going to lead it for us. Y'all give him a hand.
Beautiful gift I could ever buy Della. But that price, where would I ever get that much money? There's such a beautiful gift for Della, but with only $1.90, where would I ever get that much money? How was Christmas for 3 months from now? I can't go home, not without a present for Della. Somehow, if I went home without a present for Della, it wouldn't be Christmas. Not to me. She loved me the same, but I would feel, whatever. 4 o'clock, soon all the shops will be closed. No matter, what can I buy anyway? I wonder. Pawn shop, all goods bought and sold. Good money for used items in good condition. Definitely good condition. No, very good condition. Hello? What is it? Your sign says you buy all goods.
Must be in good condition.
I have something in very good condition.
Then why pawn it?
Why does anybody come to your shop?
Now let me see what you want me to buy.
It's a family heirloom. Been in my family for 3 generations. Must be worth quite a lot. I would have parted with it for any reason in the world. Well, except one.
Which is?
My beautiful new bride, sir. You should see her. She has such stunning long hair that flows all the way down her...
Yes, yes. Every groom thinks their new bride is beautiful.
But my Della truly is. Will you buy my pocket watch?
Don't often get a call for anything this for me.
As I told you, it's a friendly heirloom. But we are so much more. Also, much, much more. We my Della's joy and happiness by buying a gift I saw down the street. Please buy my fob, sir.
$20.
$20?
Take it or leave it.
I'll take it. Sold. My fob is sold. Thank you. And Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you, too.
That guy was so judgy.
Happy go. the near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together. If the fates allow, hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. A merry little Christmas now.
Hair. The long hair Jim loves so much. I really hope he'll take a second look at me. I know he'll say that it'll look like a Coney Island chorus girl. But I really hope he still thinks I'm pretty. Please, please make him still think I'm pretty.
Della, Della, it's Christmas Eve. Della, what happened to your...
It'll grow out again. You'll see. Several months and you'll never know.
Your beautiful long...
You don't need to worry about it. Just let's celebrate. It's Christmas Eve. I cut off my hair so I could buy you this Christmas gift.
But I don't know what to say.
Say Merry Christmas, Jim. You don't know what a wonderful, magnificent gift I've gotten for you.
But you cut off your hair.
Cut it off and sold it. Don't you like me still the same? I'm still me without my hair, aren't I?
Don't make aims think about me, Dolo. I don't think there's anything in the way of a haircut or a shampoo or a shade that made me like my girl any less. But if you see what I got you, you might see what you had me going at first.
My goodness. This is the brush I've been staring at through the window for months. This is so pretty. Thank you. How wonderful and generous of you. This must have been very, very expensive. You must have been saving up for this for a while.
Oh, wow.
Well, here, look at my gift. Wow.
Wow. But, Della, let's put our gifts down and keep them a while. They're just too nice to use as just gift. And to be honest, I kind of sold my watch to get your comb.
Seriously?
I love you, Della.
I love you too, Jim.
Merry Christmas, Della.
Merry Christmas, Jim.
But let's celebrate. It's Christmas Eve, so let's enjoy the most wondrous of seasons. We hope this Christmas holiday season may be a joyous time to each and every one of you. And during this Christmas holiday season, may you open your heart to all those you love.
And give gifts.
Even if your gift is simply...
your love.
The most wondrous gift you could ever give. Merry Christmas!
Hey, y'all. Hey. Now, I know we know this song, don't we? I'ma need a little participation. Y'all got it? All right. Hey, here we go.
Hang all the mistletoe, I'm gonna get to know you better.
This y'all part.
And as we trim the tree, how much fun is gonna be together? Fireside blazing bright, we're caroling through the night, and this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Yeah,
hey,
shake a hand now. Presents and cards are here. My world is filled with cheer and you.
When?
And as I look around, your eyes outshine the town, they do. Fireside blazing bright, we're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Shake a hand, y'all. Oh. Well, y'all, give me a This Christmas right here. And as I trim the tree, how much fun is gonna be together. Fireside blazing bright, we're caroling through the night. And this Christmas will be a very special Christmas for me. Yeah. Shake a hand, y'all. Wish your brother Merry Christmas all over the land. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas. But before we do that, let's bring this dynamic cast and company to the stage. First, let's give it up for Gary Middle School Dance Team. Come on now. Take your bow. Awesome. Let's give it up for Gary Middle School Band. Come on, Gary Middle. Woo!
Santa Claus, very good. Santa Claus, awesome. Santa Claus Lane.
Let's give it up for the Gary Middle School Choir.
Children singing, all is merry and bright. So hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight. Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus.
Also, you guys, take your bow. Also, we have Williams Elementary Choir. Come on out, you guys. Give it up for them. Give it up for the little ones. Take your bow. Last but not least, we have the Gary Middle School Actors. Come on out, you guys. Gary Middle Actors. Give it up for them. Didn't they do a great job, you guys? Give it up. Awesome, awesome, awesome. We want to thank you for allowing us to borrow your children, the teachers of this wonderful Gary Community School Corporation. We have dance, Mrs. Harrelson, choir, Mr. Jackson, band, Mr. Biltman, choir, Miss Walton, drama, Miss Hemphill, Mr. Nelson with the West Side Choir, and myself, my name is Miss Simmons at the Beverage. All right, you guys. Give it up. And I want to bring to the stage Mr. Mark Spencer.
Hey, can I tell you it's going to be great? Let's give these young people a round of applause, please. Huh? Listen, a few people I need to thank before we dismiss. And you can keep the music going underneath. Let's keep the spirit of the holiday going. That's fine. Listen, I want to thank, because it took a lot of figureheads to get together to pull this off, to work as a team, as a unit. I'd like to thank Dr. Banks, Beveridge Elementary School principal. Let's hear it for her, please.
I don't care about the presents
Miss Golson, principal of Williams School. Let's hear it for her, huh? Now, I'd be remiss if I didn't recognize our CAO. Here she is, Mrs. Kimberly Bradley. Let's say hello to her. Wonderful. Thank you so much for taking time out of your schedule. And a friend of ours I'd like to recognize and to get a few words from. I would have done it earlier. We wanted to start on time. And I want to thank her for her friendship and her partnership, for working with us, her staff. And it's very important for us to continue this work with our visual and performing arts program. Where's Ms. Dixon? Is she here? There she is. Hey. Say something, Mrs. Dixon. Welcome.
Hello, everybody.
Hey.
Greetings to you on the behalf of Gary Middle School VPA family. I'm Ms. Dixon, our principal. I'd like to recognize my administrative team, Ms. Walker, my assistant principal, and Mr. Botley. Are you here in the building? Mr. Botley, I thought I saw Mr. Botley. Okay, Mr. Botley is now here, the first man of GMS. I'm so happy, Mark, I've known you for many years, for keeping the arts alive in Gary. The arts helped to save my life. The arts is why I'm here. I was a thespian myself, one of the theaters, the actors in the theater. Thank you to the parents for coming out. I see so many parents. And to all the wonderful scholars, the brilliant scholars, outstanding, outstanding. And to all the teachers, not only Gary Middle School, but Williams, Beveridge, everybody represented. Wonderful. Keep the arts, Mr. Spencer. Keep it going.
Let's hear it for teamwork truly makes the dream work. Happy holidays. Thank you so much for coming out.